for the last time in 2020, this week on The Wire. Prices up across capital cities. NAB says first home buyers are at record levels and prices are tipped to rise 25%. G'day guys, my name is Tim Guest and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate where you can get all the top stories happening this week in finance, real estate, investment and more. Now please like, comment and share this video, and if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. So our top story for this week, prices up across capital cities. So the Real Estate Institute of Australia says the country's housing market proved to be resilient over 2020 despite the impacts of the pandemic, with price rises recorded in most states over the past quarter. Now, Australia's weighted average capital city median price for both houses and other dwellings increased over the September 2020 quarter. The latest real estate market facts report by the REIA has found. Now, REIA President Adrian Kelly says the weighted average capital city median price increased 0.4% for houses and 0.7% during the period for other dwellings. Now, over the year to September 2020, the average capital city median house price rose 3.6% to just over $773,000. While other dwellings grew 2.9% to almost $597,000. At $1.154 million, Sydney's median house price continues to be the highest amongst the capital cities, almost 50% higher than the national average. Now, Perth and Darwin have the lowest median house price across Australian capital cities at $480,000, which is 38% lower than the national average. Now, guys, for our next story. NAB says first home buyers at record levels. So young borrowers are flocking to outer city suburbs and regional Australia to get into the property market, says the National Australia Bank. Lending data from the bank confirms a surge in activity by first home buyers who are taking advantage of high levels of government assistance and cheap finance. Now, NAB is one of two major banks that were assigned first home buyer deposit places under the federal government scheme, which allows a first home buyer to secure a mortgage with a 5% deposit without needing to obtain lender's mortgage insurance. The bank found for 3 months ending in October, housing finance for first home buyers rose 21% compared with the previous period, with the strongest demand in Western Australia, Queensland, and regional New South Wales. Now, on a national level, metropolitan first home buyers grew 17% over the period, while regional uptake grew 44%. Their activity is driving house prices higher in many regional centres across Australia. And NAB executive Andy Kerr says the mortgage rush from first home buyers is at a level not seen in more than a decade. And now, guys, for our final story of the week, prices tipped to rise 25%. So house prices could surge as much as 25% as mortgage affordability reaches levels not seen since 2002. That's according to BetaShares chief economist David Bassanese. Now, BetaShares estimates are based on the median city house price combined after-tax income for an average couple and a 10% deposit with typical mortgage rates. The data implies only just over 25% of after-tax income is devoted to mortgage payments, compared to the average since mid-2002. 2004 of almost a third. Now, house prices would have to increase 25% to reduce mortgage affordability to that same level. BetaShares chief economist David Bassanese says, history suggests that the market will find equilibrium under these circumstances through a lift in house prices. That's until mortgage affordability is reduced to the long run average. Bassanese points to 2002 when house prices surged due to this factor. He says the last time our national mortgage affordability estimate was better than this was in March 2002. In the following 2 years, national house prices rose 36%. Well, guys, they're the top stories for our last week of 2020. Now, please don't forget to like, comment and share this video and follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. And from myself and all the team here at Infinite Wealth, have a Merry Christmas and a safe and happy New Year. And remember, there's only one thing in life that makes a difference, and that's action. Thanks a lot. See you in 2021.